Start learning about Emperor Ashoka. After Chandragupta renounced the throne, he was succeeded by his son Bindusara. After Bindusara's death, his son Ashoka succeeded to the throne in 273 BCE. Ashoka had been appointed the governor of Takshila and Ujjain before he came to the throne. As the governor, he had successfully crushed the revolt of Takshila. After becoming the emperor of Magadha, Emperor Ashoka launched a campaign against the state of Kalinga. Kalinga occupied the region of today's Odisha state. Emperor Ashoka conquered Kalinga. Now we can see Ashoka's empire extend from the Afghanistan in the northwest and Nepal in the north to Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh in the south, and from Bengal in the east to Saurashtra in the west, as we can see in this map. Kalinga War. Ashoka was deeply moved by the bloodshed of the Kalinga War. He decided never to wage war again, and he started believing in non-violence. Ashoka came to believe that truth, non-violence, compassion and forgiveness were the important values. Ashoka wanted to spread these teachings among the common people, and therefore he had pillar edicts and stone inscription engraved throughout his kingdom. See in this slide the pillar edicts. These writings are in the Brahmani script. In these inscriptions, he is referred to as Devanami Piyo Piya Dasi, that is beloved of the gods, and he who looks on with affection. Another inscription states that the 8 years after he ascended the throne, he made the conquest of Kalinga and had a change of heart on seeing the devastation it caused. An inscription of Emperor Ashoka at the Delhi Toda shows that he had put strict restriction on the hunting of bats, monkeys, rhinoceros and on setting fire to the forest. Emperor Ashoka's work for the spread of religion. Ashoka had embraced Buddhism, means he took the religion Buddhism. He had convened the third religious council on Buddhism at Pataliputra, means he took a meeting of the third religious council in Pataliputra. Ashoka sent his own son Mahendra and daughter Sangamitra to Sri Lanka for the spread of Buddhism. We can see in this slide. He also sent Bauddha bhikshuks to the West Asia and Central Asia for spreading Buddhism. He also built many stupas and viharas. Public welfare activities. Emperor Ashoka laid stress importance on the creation of facilities for the welfare of the people, to do good for the people. For example, he made provision for free medicines and medical treatment for the people as well as for the animals. He built many roads and plants, trees for shade on both the side of the road. He dug wells and built dharmashala. Dharmashala means the people who are traveling, they could come and stay in one place and travel the next day. Here we can see the administration during the Mauryan period. Pataliputra was the capital of the Mauryan Empire. For the sake of administration convenience, the empire was divided into four regions, as we can see in this slide, each with its own capital. Now Magadha is the center of this province. The eastern region Toshali is the present Odisha. The western region Ujjain is the present Madhya Pradesh. And the southern region Swarnanagari Karnikaji is the Karnataka. North region is Takshila, Pakistan. There were a council of ministers which advised the king in the matters of administration. There were many officers working at different levels. There was an efficient intelligence service which kept an eye on the administration on the movement of the enemies. People during the Mauryan period. During the Mauryan period, agriculture production had great importance. Trade and other occupation had also prospered well. There were many occupations like carving, engraving and ivory, weaving, dyeing cloth, and metalwork. Black glazed pottery was also produced. Here we can see in this slide, shipbuilding was carried out on a large scale. In the metalwork, the technology of making articles of other material as well as those of iron had developed. Different festivals and functions were celebrated in village and towns. Dance and music concerts were parts of entertainment. Wrestling bouts and chariot races were popular, and so were the board games and chess. Chess were called Ashtapad. And literature. During the period of Emperor Ashoka, the art of rock cut sculpture was promoted. The pillars erected by Ashoka was excellent specimen of Indian sculpture. There are excellent carvings of animal like lion, elephant, bull on the pillars. The chakra or wheel on the Ashoka pillar at Sarnath has a place of honor on the Indian national flag. The pillar has lion on all four sides, but only three are visible from the front. This is the official seal of Government of India, as we can see in this slide. Cave sculpture of Bararba Hill, carved during the period of Ashoka, are well known. These caves are in Bihar. They are the oldest cave sculptures in India. After the death of Emperor Ashoka, the Mauryan Empire began to decline. After the Mauryan, many new states and some empires also emerged in India. The Mauryan Empire was the largest empire in ancient India. In the next chapter, we shall discuss the political and the cultural happenings in the post-Mauryan period. Thank you.